Good afternoon, everyone. So, I am from Team 11, and we will be presenting our market research and business plan based on mushroom. Firstly, I will tell you about my team members. Like, we are four members in team. Myself, Bhushan, then Tejaswi Namgudi, Dithika Saini, and Mukul. Before starting presentation, I would like to tell you that the four names which you are seeing in your screen are not ordinary persons. They
Wow.
are very rich,
Wow.
not by money, but by ideas. They are
Wow.
very entrepreneurial and risk-taking personalities. So
Oh.
back in 2019, after doing their agriculture, study in agriculture, they met and decided to do something in agriculture to revolutionize the industry. So they decided to go with mushroom. And these are the basic five reasons why they selected mushroom. Global mushroom market value is expected to exceed $50 billion in the next 7 years. Basically, the demand will be increasing in restaurants, supermarkets, cafeterias, and hotels. That will definitely increase the mushroom market. Second reason is shift consumer preference towards vegan foods. An increasing meat substitute demand is projected to aid the mushroom market over the coming years. Third reason is shifting consumer preferences towards processed food consumption. There are a lot of value addition opportunities in the mushroom that are yet to be fully exploited. Fourth reason is dominance of rice wheat cropping system in India. Mushroom cultivation is based on recycling of the agriculture residues, which are available in huge quantities in every corner of the country. You will be amazed to know that black carbon emission from biomass burning is the second largest contributor to the current global warming. At present, the areas with rice wheat cropping system of India is facing a tough challenge to handle the mounting crop residues. So mushroom cultivation can effectively utilize these agricultural residues to make rich substances that will be beneficial for the whole consumer market. The fifth reason is there is an opportunity to exploit the commercial utilization of mushroom substrate left after cultivation for preparation of organic manure, vermicompost, briquettes. So this particular domain of mushroom industry is not exploited, and that can be exploited to make this business very beneficial. So after deciding to go for a market research, we did two type of research: primary research and secondary research. For primary research, we exploited floated a Google form, the questionnaire method, and the secondary research we referred to some market reports already existed to understand the industry. So firstly, let's understand the market analysis of mushroom market analysis. So in India, there are a lot of small individual farmers who are growing mushroom, but there are very big corporate players also, like Messrs. Himalaya International Private Limited, Messrs. Agro Dutch Mushrooms Private Limited. So these are really very big names. They produce approximately 1,000 tons per annum. We can't compete with their volume because they are very established. We are a startup, so we have to do some innovation. We adopt some blue ocean strategies to compete with them. Now, the second thing is about the mushroom market, that most of the players are involved in primary production. There is a lack of value addition in this industry. Third is mushroom is heavily labor intensive industry, because the main reason is that mushroom is very prone to deterioration. Like, if you its shelf life is very less. If you don't harvest the crop in night and send to the market in morning, it will be totally deteriorated. You will not get any food. So you need a large amount of labor to continue in this industry. The fourth is marketing of mushroom in India is not organized. Small vendors are the main thing is marketing. So on the basis of this, we come to a conclusion that we need some type of strategies. Basically, we can add some value to the already existed products. Like, not going for directly selling mushroom, we can make some processed products like chips or sweets. And the second is we can concentrate on marketing also. Now, after understanding market, we went to the consumers to understand their preferences, that what the consumer wants. So these are the results basically which we got from our questionnaire, and according to our research, 64% of respondents prefer processed mush products. So it backed the already existing data that the Indian mushroom industry is not very processed and the consumers want the processed products. So we decided to process it, and we had some options like chips, sweets, I already mentioned. Second result is 68% of respondents prefer button over mothers over others. So that is also backed by our sector research from the market reports. In India, a lot of work is done on button, but the other categories are still unexploited. Third is 68% of respondents consume mushroom occasionally. So this point really attracted our team to this industry, because these 68% people are consuming mushroom occasionally. So we can convert them to regular consumers. And if we are able to do that, we will be really very successful. Fourth is more than 90% people had given a nutritional rating of more than 7. So this also shows how much beneficial this mushroom industry can be, because people already know that mushroom is very much nutritional. So if we provide them the product, they will definitely buy for this nutrition purpose. Fifth is 70% respondents buy mushrooms from local vendors. So basically these three points helped us to decide our marketing strategies, because a lot of persons are already buying from local vendors. So we can go with collaboration with local vendors, or we can do some innovation in marketing also. Now, 98% of respondents want 200 to 500 gram packing. So this helped us to understand the type of packing which we can provide. And the last 82% respondents prefer laminated packaging instead of canned. So this analysis and the existing marketing reports helped us to make our great enterprise, which we discussed by Tejaswini in the coming slides. Tejaswini, you can go ahead.
Yeah. So the first reason we have started this is like we focus more on the high protein and rich nutrients. These days immunity is everything. So we provided the high quality mushrooms which were filled with proteins and at affordable prices. This also is a good step to reduce unemployment. And can you go to the next slide, sir? Okay, so our company name is Mushroom Masters Private Limited. So this was established on 14th of February 2019 in Hyderabad. We sell fresh mushrooms as well as the mushroom chips, which are snacks. So this was started by Mr. Bhushan, Tejaswini, Ritika, and Mukul. Sir, can you go to the next slide? So our vision is to be the best supplier, so major supplier of quality button mushrooms and also the processed mushroom chips in Hyderabad. Initially in Hyderabad, and next we want to eventually spread our business. So to achieve this vision, we are practicing some sustainable farming practices by growing our edible mushrooms in a controlled environment, and we are trying our best to use more organic substrates. Also, the objectives of our company is to produce mushrooms fresh in least prices, and also to be the pioneer, making aware of nutritional values, creating unemployment, and also creating employment, and also with quality. So next slide. So this is our business structure. Our Bhushan sir is our CEO, and I'll be taking care of our farm. And our Ritika ma'am, she is taking care of our finances, and Mukul sir is the marketing head. We have a team with good staff and workers who will be helping us in everything. And so can you go to the next slide? So about the product description, we have two products. One is the fresh mushroom and the other one is the chips. Fresh mushrooms, we know that it is like it can be used in soups, sauces, and curries and many other items. It is very high in essential amino acids and rutin. And also the chips, because these chips absorb low amount of oil and everything, this is a very good snack. this snack is combined with this potato also. Can you go to the next slide? So this is our unit where we'll be growing the mushrooms. So the customer benefits is the most of the people don't know what these mushrooms consist of, and so they reject it. This is completely zero fat and zero cholesterol food. So these days people are after the keto diets, and they are going with very good diets which consist of low cholesterol, low fat. And this mushroom is a very good substitute for that, and it consists of vitamin B, proteins, minerals, and it is very good for blood circulation and blood vessels. It also reduces the breast cancer and prostate cancer cells, prevents the prostate cancer cells. Next, sir. Yeah, this will be continued by our marketing head, Mukul sir.
Thank you, ma'am, and thank you, sir. Good afternoon, everyone. So from here I will start with the main and critical topic, SWOT analysis. The SWOT is a critical thing for the business. That not only, if we done the SWOT, that not only make our competitor effective and also make us to become a unique brand in the market. We have some strength, weakness, opportunity and threats of our business. So I asked Bhushan sir to make the next slide. Firstly, we will discussing about the strength. Why we were going about that business? The main thing is that we will go with the new idea in that business. And you see, there is one presentation done before us. They were discussing about the fish market. All of us are going for the non-veg protein. So we are discussing about, we are going to the veg protein. So mushroom is a well-managed and well-product and hygienic product to give the nutrition in very low cost and a very hygienic manner. So that is the very high strength of our business. And another thing is that we will create the employment. As Tejaswini ma'am said, that we will give the training to the unemployed people in that area where we start the business. And another thing is that we will get the raw material at very low cost, less investment and less, and the major climatic condition are good at that time. So I ask Bhushan sir to next slide, please. I'm discussing about the weakness. There is some weakness and there's strength in the business. Always some weakness are present in the business. So that's not a weakness. We will conduct the weakness into opportunity. Mushroom is the bigger weakness of our business is that mushroom can be spoiled in 3 to 4 days. For that, we will go for the canned product, but the product is getting very, very high and expensive, and it contains a lot of things. And the major business is that lack of awareness. Everyone go about the non-veg and everyone go about the paneer for protein source. We will create the awareness. That took some time, but that not a weakness for our business. That's why we choose the mushroom market. Next slide, sir. There are a lot of opportunity present in the business. That's why we will go for there. The major opportunity is that as you see, a lot of canned product are present in the market. That will be very expensive. That's why our CEO sir and other finance teachers and other people ask me to go for mushroom, raw mushroom. That will be helpful for the people and there will be affordable price. That's the good thing. And we will adopt the latest technology from the, because we have a very good people like CEO sir are having very good knowledge. And another thing is that people having, nowadays we are building about, people are more conscious about nutritional and immunity. Now, you know, coronavirus and other diseases are going on, so they will more focus on immunity. So that's a bigger advantage to go for nutritional product and mainly for veg animal, veg product. There are some threats are always present in the business, but when we do the SWOT analysis, we make it possible that we become a market leader, not become a challenger or not become a, we are only focus about the leader. We don't discuss about the challenger. So there are some threats that some pest management, some cost are there. But you know, sir recently said we are rich people according to knowledge, and we have some funds that will be given by Ritika ma'am in the next slide. So I will ask you to, sir, next slide, please. So firstly, thank you to my team who gave me 14 members for the marketing. The main thing in the business is that marketing. If we made the product and we don't know how to market the product, that will be bigger disadvantage for us. We have a good quality product, good thing, but to know about the marketing, I will thankful to my team who gave me the 14 member to do such marketing. So firstly, the marketing mix means we use some actions and tactics to promote our business. There, as you, as sir also mentioned, there are four P's for the marketing. First is, First is product. Sir, going on, I will explain. First is product. Mainly, our main agenda of our company is not cope up with the quality. We always, as Bhushan sir done the research, and there are a lot of people, and Ritika ma'am also say, no need of tension about the money. We have a lot of money, but only thing is that we never ever cope up with the quality. We give the best quality product to our customer so that our customer will be satisfied, and about the sizes, we will provide the best product, and we get a market research and we know what type of product they want within the 200 gram packaging and 500 gram packaging. And our service is well managed because we have a major service. As you know, there is a brand name Delivering Goodness. We will provide the Delivering Goodness, and the major thing is that that's our point of difference. We will provide we'll make a bond with the customer. We'll not only provide, we will not, our business objective is not to make profit. Business objective is to get lifetime consumer goals, customers. And we have and another thing is that taste. Price, we will take the least price. We will provide the best. I want to also discuss that we will not take care of price. We will provide the best product. As we have some innovative approach, we will try our level best to give the least price of the product, give some discount on a special occasion. And another thing is the promotion. We will use the push and pull approach for the promotion. We will go for the channels. We will go for the locations and transport. Push approach, we will ask the retailer to take their product. We will provide some discount to that product initially. Pull approach, we will provide a good quality product to the market, to the consumer. They will ask other consumer to buy that product. That is our business strategy for the making business. And the place, initially we will start. Sir, we will. I will take care of that. Only 1 minute, I take bus. Place. The main thing about the place is that initially we will start in the Hyderabad, but we have a growth expansion, as Tejasni ma'am also said, we will go for another countries. And for that, we have a best strategy. We don't, we will, because in the machine, the bigger advantage is that we don't want a land. So we will discussing, we will take care of small and marginal farmer. And employ that, and provide the employment to that persons, and create a contact farming in the other countries to promote our business, to make profit. Our main focus is quality, and another focus is making well-being for the farmer. So we will try our level best to provide everything for the farmer. Next slide, sir.
So we also want to tell financer, please make it fast.
Yeah, I'm only taking 1 minute. I know. I'm not taking bore you guys. Marketing strategy. I'm ending there. This is the major thing about the market strategy we made. There are, as you know, the market strategy, a lot of people having different market strategy, but that are the major objective of our company to promote the thing. First is, as I'm already discussed, we will never ever cope up with the quality. Another thing is that we have a customer satisfaction. That our major goal to get the customer satisfaction. We will get the feedback on the daily, on the weekly basis about the customer, about the people we have employed to give the product. Another thing is that we will growing a relationship with the customer, and we will provide the quality product. That may be the good relationship with customer. And another thing is that customer retention. We will retain the old customer and try to make the new customer. We will never cope up with old customer. Old is gold always. We will go with that. And another thing is that about the SWOT analysis, we will focus on competitor activity and become a leader. We will not only, we will try our innovative approach. As already discussed, we will never ever want to become a market challenger. We want to become a market leader at all. Another thing is that growing emphasis on global thinking, as the Jaswini ma'am said, we will go for other countries, and we will definitely grow our business and help other farmers and other community. And promotion strategy, we go for different things. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Give me a lot of time. And
we have financial also. So being the chief operating officer,
I take your time.
It's okay, sir. It's okay. Being the chief operating officer of this business plan, I'll be looking after all the operations. So our go-to-market strategy will be different for both raw mushroom and mushroom chips. For raw mushroom, we'll be targeting the local mandis and the grocery marts and hotel and restaurants where we'll be selling our raw mushroom, raw button mushroom, and for mushroom chips, we'll be going for wholesale markets and local retailers, also the food marts like V-Mart and big bazaars and all, and online B2B and B2C platforms like Amazon and IndiaMart and etc. Moving ahead. So coming to the finances, which is the most important part of any business plan. So for button mushroom cultivation, our overall total expenditure would be 1,50,000, in which all the construction and other things will be taken care of. Moving ahead, for entire 1 year, we have a recurring business, finances, which will cost us around 1,60,000. And apart from this, we will also apply for a subsidy given by Hyderabad government on mushroom cultivation. Next. So coming to finances for mushroom chips factory. So to set up a mushroom chips factory, we need a machinery. We need edible oil, flavors and spices. We need packaging material and salt, which is most important. So all this will cost us around 7,30,000. So our overall yearly expenditure would come out to be near about 16,60,000. So how we'll be getting our revenue is, we have like set a price for raw mushroom 160 rupees per kg, and for chips we have kept a price of rupees 120 per 100 gram of chips packet, and accordingly our daily yield is around 25 kg of mushrooms, and so we get a daily earning of 9,200, and our yearly revenue comes out to be 33,58,000, subtracting the expenditure, we get a profit of nearly about 16,98,000. So our future outlook is like, we are just a startup for now, and we are planning to grow to other markets in Hyderabad itself, and later on we are planning to go to a cash cow stage by expanding to various states.
Yeah.
So at the end, I would like to conclude by saying, like, mushroom is a kind of neglected nowadays. People are quite lacking in the nutritional advantage of mushroom. So our motto is to provide various snacks of mushrooms. For now, we have come up with mushroom chips, but later we'll be coming up with new products like mushroom sweets and mushroom powder. So ready to use things so that people can consume mushroom and get benefits of mushroom.
Thank you very much. Oh my God, that's a great presentation. Great presentation. Thanks a lot. Congratulations to Team 11. Ritika, Bhushan. Then we had Tejashwini and Mukul. Fantastic job. I really appreciated your enthusiasm.